Well, it hasn't happened, and it's been terribly disappointing to me. And that's why I'm saying I am encouraged by the conversation. I have to see the concrete action. And it's not that I don't trust the word of the president. It's just that I need to see the concrete measures that are going to be taken. And if we don't take those concrete measures, and if the resolution doesn't allow it, then obviously I can't support it. It's almost as bad as not passing a resolution as passing a resolution that doesn't allow us to take action that reverses the situation on the battlefield so that Bashar Assad will sooner or later leave. The only way he's going to leave is if he thinks he's losing. I think the president needs to talk to the American people from the Oval Office, from his desk in the Oval Office, and show the American people again these pictures of the bodies stacked up. Show them the horrific situation of 1 million children refugees, of 100,000 killed, of the destabilizing effects throughout the region. This is not confined to Syria, as you know, Charlie. It is spreading throughout the region. Iraq is now unraveling. The King of Jordan is not going to stay in power. Lebanon, the whole situation, and Iran is the key to it. And if the Iranians prevail here, and we don't retaliate, this will be a huge victory for Iran as they progress on their path towards nuclear weapons. There's a lot at stake here.